Thank you. Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to our summer concert. I'm sure that some of you will be here at our Christmas concert, so obviously we've got a complete different programme for you this evening from those few months ago. The choir you see before me is largely based on the old Oakdale Youth Choir of the 80s and 90s, but also with members from more recent choirs of mine, Caerphilly Children's Choir and Youth Singers, and Caerphilly Community Chorus. Our first soloist tonight is David Lawrence Myers. David was a founder member of the choir back in 1985, but our relationship goes back much earlier than that, to when David was an 8-year-old lad in Mytacomer, where we lived at the time, and he came along to me for piano lessons. And he had many years of piano lessons from me, and it's the fact that he had piano lessons with me that he's become a professional singer and not a professional pianist. Make of that what you will. He was a pupil at Lewis Boys School and then went on to Huddersfield University, where he took a degree in music, then furthered his vocal studies at the Welsh College of Music and Drama, and also in London at the, and it's got straight out of my head,
Guildhall,
thank you, Guildhall School of Music and Drama in London. He then set on a career in opera and sang in a number of opera companies up and down the land, and taking many of the well-known roles, probably the best-known was the role of Figaro, which I'm sure we are familiar with. Then he decided to turn his attention to music theatre and was a member of the cast of Phantom in the West End for many years, taking various roles and understudying a main role as well. Before he then joined the cast of Les Miserables on their 25th anniversary tour, which was a very special occasion, very special tour around the UK. He took the part of the bishop, which is the person who comes on stage to sing the very first solo, but also understudied the role of Javert, one of the main roles, and sang that a number of times. And my wife Gail and I were in the audience in the Millennium Centre in Cardiff for the 25th anniversary performance. And to see David come on and take that opening solo was a very enjoyable sensation, to see one of my former students there up on stage. He's done a lot of concert work and been very successful in competitions and won a number of awards. So please give a warm welcome to Sing Stars from Les Miserables, our baritone soloist this evening, David Lawrence Myers.
Returns and returns, and is always the same.
suffer fell, you fall in flame. And so it must be, for so it is written on the doorway to paradise, that those who falter and those who fall must pay the price. Lord, let me find him, that I may see him safe behind bars.
Into the 20th century, our opening three pieces went back as far as the 16th century. The setting of William Blake's The Lamb by John Taverner has long been a favourite of ours, and we're going to begin with a setting of Psalm 67 by the Welsh composer William Matthias, who wrote it for the wedding of Charles and Diana on the 29th of July 1981. Now remember, it's the 29th of July, because that's my wedding anniversary as well. We were married 9 years previously. He never wrote to us to ask for permission, nor did he invite us, but then I guess that's royal prerogative for you.
Thank you.
me tell you a little bit about a clarinet choir. The clarinet family possesses instruments that cover almost the full range of the orchestral sound, from the very top to the very bottom. And in the ensemble tonight, we do have quite an array, from the small E-flat clarinet, which Martin plays, here we are, the B-flat clarinet, could there be B-flat players hold the instruments up as well? That's the normal one, through to these wonderful beasts on the end. I am talking about the instruments. That's the bass clarinet, we've got five pieces for you. A rondo by Purcell, which many of these, as ex-students of mine at Oakdale Comprehensive School, will recognise the melody as being that used in the Young Person's Guide to the Orchestra. Then we have a complete change of style for a Lover's Prayer, where our principal clarinetist, Paul, is going to play an alto sax solo with the ensemble. Then we go back to the time of George I for a piece from a hornpipe and the water music, performed 301 years ago on the River Thames, really. Then a nice lively rondo by Mozart from his Serenade for 13 wind instruments. And finally, the arrival of the Queen of Sheba, which is a wedding favourite for the entry of the bride. So five pieces from the South Wales Clarinet Choir and musical director Linda Jeffrey. Please give them a warm welcome. Well, thank you to Linda and the South Wales Clarinet Choir. So to end our first half, we're going to combine with our beautiful motet of Mozart's Ave Verum Corpus. Then we'll have an interval. There won't be refreshments in the interval, but there'll be plenty of refreshments afterwards. So please do come and join us downstairs at the very end of the concert, where we've got all sorts of goodies for you. So here's Ave Verum Corpus by Mozart. Starting with a march from the English Folk Song Suite by Ray Vaughan Williams, who was very interested in folk music, and with a couple of other musicians collected lots of folk songs and folk dance music that he used in his own compositions. And then a brisk, light-hearted piece called Clarinata, where Paul is once again our soloist, this time on clarinet. And then we switch to Porgy and Bess, probably one of the greatest 20th century operas. and the aria I Got Plenty of Nothing. And we're going to finish in party mood, or you're off to Israel for a bit of klezmer music, which is get your toes tapping. So please welcome back Southwind's Clarinet Choir and our musical director, Linda Jeffrey.
Thank you. Thank you.
thank you very much once again to the South West Clarinet Choir and Dorinda. We've now got three pieces, more contemporary pieces, Bridge Over Troubled Water by Paul Simon, and my favourite Welsh folk song, my arrangement of Adel Anna Moore. All My Trials is a spiritual from the Bahamas, and I first heard that in 1986 when a choir from Maryland, from a high school in Maryland, from North Harford High School, came across and visited, and I was quite blown away by this particular arrangement, so it's been in our repertoire ever since. Now, we do have a very special connection with North Harford High School. Oakdale Youth Choir visited there twice, 1989 and 1995. They came over here on four visits altogether, and families have linked up ever since then, and they're really good links. And we've got an example tonight. We have a young lady singing in the choir tonight from North Harford High School in Maryland. Here's Julia. Here she is. Here she is. Rest of the choir how to sing in Welsh, and managing very well indeed. Her mother Chris was involved in a number of exchanges, came over herself and hosted when we were there. It just happened to be, I shouldn't tell you her age, but she had a 17th birthday, oh damn it, 17th birthday 2 days ago, wasn't it? Yes, so I think a chorus. What should we do in English, then in Welsh? Okay, here we go, my son. Julia.
Yeah.
We know the result.
Take these broken wings and learn to fly.
Woo!
Just before our last item, I would like to call upon our choir spokesperson, Gareth, who would like to say a few words and make a few presentations.
Target after tonight. <going to it. laughs> I've got to be honest, like, it was brilliant, particularly listening to the clarinet choir. You're all legacy of the band in time. I'm not talking, it was brilliant. The last time I sweated like this was my wedding day. Not because it was my wedding day. choir started 85. Well, some of us started 81, 82 when we were in the choir. Can I have a show of hands, please? Those who were born after 1981? After. Getting old. All Michelle's a month older, so it's fine with me. That's okay. All right, so we've got a couple of awards to make. Some gifts that I'm going to start with. I think it's Linda.
Travel C. join us in the anthem. Please stand in for Hen Radwan Hadau.